I have come here to chew bubblegum and kick ass. And I'm all out of bubblegum.
So guys, John P. Claymore here, and the Supreme Court did something useful for a change. They went 9-0 ruling in favor of the Fourth Amendment in this case here today. This is breaking news. This is also very, very big because it actually influences the next case, which is the Second Amendment case, which determines your right whether you can carry a gun or not. All right. Now, obviously, D.C. Heller determined that you could own a weapon. I mean, there's the Second Amendment. I mean, and see, really, really quick, guys, before you get into this, make sure you hit that like button, make sure you subscribe, make sure you share this video. Also, at the same time, hit the notification bell, leave a comment in the comment section. I will post a couple of links to these cases in the comment section. I'll try to pin them in there because for whatever reason, I can't really, like, you know, actually put it in the description section, but I will put it in the comment section so that way you guys can see it. So let's look at this. So the Supreme Court, 9-0, decided that, law enforcement can't just walk inside your house with no warrant or anything and take anything away. Now, the previous video I made was in response, a quick two-minute response to Prince Harry saying he did not understand the First Amendment. The First Amendment is one of the main things we wanted to fight for in the American Revolution. However, the thing is this right here, the thing that actually forced the revolution was the Fourth Amendment, unlawful search, unlawful seizure, your right to privacy. This is one of the biggest things that Rand Paul goes on about. You remember back in 2016 when he was against the Patriot Act where he said, it's what we fought the revolution over? That's correct, because Chris Christie's a neocon and an SOB, and he's not on our side. I've never been a fan of Chris Christie. So the thing is this right here, and I remember when the Patriot Act was first signed. Now, obviously, this whole entire ordeal is about guns, of course, but I'll get on that in a second. When the Patriot Act was signed, I was like 17. I was about to join the military, and at the same time, I was actually okay with trying to find the terrorists and using those kinds of means. Of course, I get to my late 20s, and I realize this right here wasn't such a good idea because Obama's actually targeting, drone striking his own citizens. All right, so this is one of the main reasons why the Fourth Amendment is so important, is your right to privacy. Also, with these vaccine passports and crap like that right there, I'm pretty sure now that's going to pretty much get away with any possibility of that. Even though the Biden administration is saying they're not going to go through that, there's actually different reasons why they're not going to go through with that, okay? But let's take a look at this really quick. So the Supreme Court finally, in a 9-0 ruling, said, hey, look, you can't just walk inside somebody's house and take their stuff. Now, this is surprising to me because I figured Kagan or Sotomayor would break. I had a feeling that John Roberts would break. Now, the next case, this right here influences the next case a lot. And it also lets you know where the court's going to go. Now, I don't believe you're going to get a 9-0 decision on this constitutional carry case. You're probably going to get like a 6-3 or a 5-4. Who knows? You may even get a 7-2 because Breyer may even side with the conservatives on this one. I doubt it, but you know, you never know. There's always room for optimism. You don't want a political Supreme Court, all right? And the reason why this is so important is because this is right here is trying to clamp down on our rights. It's trying to say, look, no president, no governing body can actually trample on your rights. Now, one of the reasons why the Democratic Party, especially the left, decides this court packing stuff is not because they plan on packing the court. They're doing this because they know the Supreme Court does not want to be political and they don't want to be packed. So they run their mouth about packing the court and crap like that, so that way justice will give them favorable opinions in the future. That's the reason why they do it. That's the real reason why they scream about packing the court. But guys, today was a great day because now your Fourth Amendment right has been protected, and I believe that right there will bode very, very well for your Second Amendment going in the future. All right, guys, if you like my content, hit that like button. Please subscribe. Please share this video. Also, hit the notification bell. Leave a comment in the comment section. One more thing, too. I'll be posting more videos to my actual sports page, my sports, actual sports channel. It's called Anti-Woke Sports. I'm going to leave a link in the description box. There's one video there already, but it was just kind of a video just to kind of get started. But I'll start posting that there today, and I'll leave a link to that channel in the comment section. Once again, guys, thank you for subscribing, and I'll see you guys later.
Now, hold on. You ain't the first son of a bitch to wake up out of their dreams.